Good morning, dear student of class 12. Today I am going to start your snapshot. Lesson number 1. Lesson name, the third level, written by Jack Finney. About the author. Walter Burden Jack Finney. Lifetime, October 2, 1911 to November 14, 1995, was an American author. His best known works are science fiction and thrillers, including The Body Snatchers and Time and Again. The former was the basis of the 1956 film Invasion of the Body Snatchers and its remix. Then you go through the summary of this lesson. In New York, the Grand Central Station has two levels. Nonetheless, Charlie, a 31-year-old city resident, talks the three exist a third level. Talks that there exists a third level. Also, he claims that he has been there. To talk about these problems, he visits a psychiatrist friend. He calls it a walking dream with fulfillment. And explains Charlie's psychology by saying that the modern world is full of fear, insecurity, war and worry, and everybody wants to escape to some temporary refuge from reality. As for him, hobbies like stamp collection is an indicator of this escape. At times, the Grand Central Station seems like a maze to Charlie. While taking the subway earlier, he had lost his way a couple of times. One time he entered the lobby of the Roosevelt Hotel, while the other time he appeared at an office building that was three blocks away. However, this time he loses his way and something unique occurs. Charlie visits the third level. In the silent halfway, Charles keeps walking, turning left and sloping downward until he touches an architecturally old station which is totally different from two familiar levels. Moreover, this old small room with fewer ticket counters and train gates, a wooden information board, wavering open flame gas lights and brass spittoons, all this reminds him of the architecture of the 1800s. Further, he sees people in outdated outfits. When he noticed the date in the newspaper, the world, he sees 11 June 1894. When he tries to buy two tickets, he realizes that he needs old currency. He always wanted to travel to Galesburg with his wife, Louisa. Back in his head, it is a wonderful town still, with big old frame houses, huge lawns and tremendous trees. The place has pleasant town still with big old frame house, huge lawns and tremendous trees. This place is a pleasant and long summer dusk and where people have ample of time. Hence the next day during lunch, he exchanges $300 for old currency amounting to some 200 only. In addition, the amount does not bother him as he believes that everything there will be cheaper. However, he could never again find the corridor that leads into the third level. When her wife came to know about this, she asked him to stop looking. Unexpectedly, his friend Sam Weiner also disappeared, and his wife keeps on looking for him for in the weekends. Moreover, Sam was the one who Charlie shares his idea about Galesburg. Charlie inherited the hobby of stamp collection from his grandfather, and someday while looking at the stamp collection, Charlie finds a letter that was earlier not there. Also, it has the postmark on a faded 6-cent stamp with a picture of President Garfield. Further, the envelope reads as 18 July 1894 to Charles' grandfather in Galesburg, and it addresses Charlie. In the letter, Sam tells Charlie that he has reached Galesburg, and he invites Charlie and Louisa after. After going to stamp and coin shop, he gets to know that Sam exchanged $800 for old currency bills to establish his business in Galesburg. Besides, Sam was none other than Charlie's psychiatrist. Dear children, this is the summary of your lesson. You have to read the question answer of this lesson, long and short question and answers. Thanks guys, and have a good day.